Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Shy Guy Rocks 1998, though you can all just call me Matt. Welcome back to some more WWE 2K14. We're in the Universe era now, starting with WrestleMania 25. John Cena, Edge, Big Show for the World Heavyweight Championship.
As global trends shift and change, so does WWE. New faces emerge as WCW fails to match WWE's popularity. And while the Attitude Era ushered in highly charged and explosive elements to the WWE universe, a new term defines sports entertainment in the new millennium.
Who among you has enough ruthless aggression? I'm a main event player. These fools in the background. I take over you, and then I take over SmackDown.
There is no doubt John Cena generates the emotion out of our fans.
While there was an influx of new
Don't
superstars...
Don't fucking crap out on me, disc!
...still remaining.
The largest athlete!
I am the biggest, baddest superstar to ever hit this company.
I have never seen one individual dominate like this.
As a result, superstars old and new focused on one common vision. Domination. And familiar faces re-emerged with ruthless intentions.
The ultimate opportunist has done it again.
I'm a rated R superstar, and you better get used to it.
Edge, the Big Show, they have done every tactic to try to keep me away from the World Heavyweight Championship.
Wait a minute, Cena's in bad trouble now.
Disc, no, don't do it! Are you fucking with me here? Seriously? Oh my fucking god. Following the main event of the March 2 episode of Raw, SmackDown General Manager Vicky Guerrero announced that her husband Edge would defend his World Heavyweight Championship against Big Show at the 25th anniversary of WrestleMania. On the March 9th episode of Raw, Vicky announced to the surprise of both competitors that their World Heavyweight Championship match was now a triple threat affair involving John Cena. It was soon revealed that John Cena was extorting Vicky with footage of her affair with Big Show. As a result, Vicky booked a match pitting Edge against Cena with herself serving as a special guest referee. As Edge and Cena battled, Big Show joined Edge in the ring. Edge speared Cena, Vicky slapped him, and Big Show delivered a knockout punch. Edge, however, sent the biggest message of the night when he speared Big Show. I'm hitting cancel here because I do not want this match ending up glitching. So I'm just gonna hit that, skip the fucking thing, and just let the whole thing load. Just let that whole thing load. Alright. And there are no subtitles. Great!
One fall. And is for the World Heavyweight Championship. Making his way to the
ring. When this happens.
Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing 241 pounds.
My disc is
the
fucked.
World Heavyweight Champion, the rated R superstar, Edge.
Over 70,000 fans greeting the World Heavyweight Champion. An entrance befitting an 8-time world champion. The World Heavyweight Championship is on the line. Three men will be in this match, but only one man can leave with that gold. Well, in a triple threat match, three men, as you say, battle at the same time. There can only be one winner, and the champion Edge is at a big disadvantage.
Whoa, speaking of big, I don't know what Big Show's going to be introduced weighing tonight, but I'm hearing around 485. Yeah, we talked to Big Show last week before his big match with John Cena on Monday Night Raw. The Big Show says he's weighing in at 485 pounds.
Well, that's what he said. But when he got on the scale said, one at a time, please.
And introducing the challenger. First, standing 7 feet tall.
Thank God it was only for Edge's entrance.
The Big Show.
It's the Big Show!
Newbury, Massachusetts, weighing 240 pounds, John Cena.
There is no one in the WWE that evokes as much...
Now I know this was not Cena's entrance in Mania 25. I watched that fucking match. This was not Cena's entrance. I guess the Xbox 360 just can't... You can't do enough models, damn it. Either way, let's do this. For the World Heavyweight Championship. Let's fucking go!
This one is
Double Team Big Show. Come on, Edge. Help me out here.
Edge was scheduled to face the Big Show for the WWE Championship here at WrestleMania.
You got him, Edge. You got it.
At the contract signing.
Yeah. John Cena shows
up. Yeah, I'ma just do this because I gotta do a five knuckle shuffle on Edge.
Contract signing off to the confusion of everyone.
Vicky then the rules of this triple threat matchup. Edge is the champion, but does not have to be involved in the decision to lose that title. First man to gain pinfall or submission will become
You can't see me!
Champion.
Big Show?
A Big Show? Could you not?
Of a match so quickly, JR.
Edge has made a career of finding or making an opportunity for himself. That might be his biggest attribute. Edge always finds a way to come out on top.
Well, some people call it being lucky, but Edge makes his
the expression.
All right, the next objective. Three standing grapple moves to Big Show in the ring.
He is focused on one thing, winning the World Heavyweight Championship.
Well, Big Show is no stranger to gold. He's the only man to hold the WWE.
Cena with a short
kick. Oh, Cena with a kick to the knee.
Getting the big man off balance.
Big man off balance right there.
Some
into the legs.
Edge drop kicking the ring steps right into the knee.
It seems Edge and Cena have a common enemy here. The giant known as Big Show.
Cena's putting his body on the line with that high risk maneuver.
King, I'm not sure who got the better of that exchange.
I'm pretty sure it was Edge.
Wow, he's still down after that.
All right, we need to get Big Show to critical damage and attempt to AA him.
Big Show.
And fuck you, Show. Fuck you.
Can we end this match now? Well, there's no
Never.
Sportsman-like conduct going on.
Cracks him with the chair. Remember the rules, ladies and gentlemen. Big Show beating John Cena is the same as Big Show beating Edge. Either way, the Show leaves the champion.
Big Show's fists are so big, JR.
Fuck
it's
you.
Like getting
fuck
punched
you.
In the face with a Christmas ham.
The Big Show is an anomaly. A man of his size should not be able to move as quickly as he does. It creates a huge matchup problem,
Owie.
Pun intended, for Cena and Edge.
Every time he has to get up, it takes more and more effort.
Man, Fuck. He came down hard from that back body drop. It's not something that is common, but man, the Big Show's starting to walk on spaghetti legs here. Edge is a man who made a career out of TLC
fuck
matches.
You, fuck you, fuck
Edge
you!
Edge is an innovator. Let's don't count Edge out just yet, because I'm sure he's got something up his sleeve.
Edge always has something
no!
up his sleeve. You don't win as many championships as Edge has without having a game plan.
Edge has earned the nickname the ultimate opportunist for a reason. He waits for the right time to strike. Aligns himself with the right people and then makes his move.
And he usually earns championship gold as a result.
And fools him with the reversal.
I'm sorry, that was no reversal.
The number one contender against Vicky Guerrero's husband, Edge. But Cena used the controversial footage to be here tonight.
Come on!
Last week, it was Edge imploring Cena to take out the Big Show. Tonight, we've already seen Edge imploring the Big Show here.
The Big Show is in serious trouble here. Make no mistake about it. There is
come on.
More physically imposing.
Oh, my God. Ow, my back.
Edge
for the sleeper. He's trying to get that sleeper locked in.
This is one way to put the Big Show out.
Come on. Oh, no. Oh, no. Holy fucking shit. He had both men up and the attitude adjustment to Big Show. Oh, no. And another one. Attitude adjustment to Edge onto Big Show. Come on. One, two, three. That was not as hard as I thought it was going to be. New World Heavyweight Champion, John Cena.
I couldn't even talk for a minute. My mouth was agape when I saw Cena lift both Big Show and Edge simultaneously.
Can you believe the strength of Cena? For winning that match, we've gotten the Rated R WWE Championship. I'm starting to lose my voice. Edge's Mania 25 attire, Big Show's Mania 25 attire, and John Cena's Mania 25 attire. Randy Orton won the 2009 Royal Rumble match and earned a world title shot of his choosing. During a heated conflict, Orton RKO'd Stephanie McMahon, which enraged the WWE champion, Triple H. On the March 2nd episode of Raw, Orton was convinced by Triple H to use his title opportunity in a match against him for the WWE Championship at the 25th anniversary of WrestleMania. The following week on Raw, Triple H came out with a sledgehammer and attacked Orton. 1 week later, Orton would attack Triple H and handcuff him to the top rope. Stephanie came out and begged Orton not to attack her husband. Instead, with Triple H looking on helplessly, Orton DDT'd Stephanie.
This next contest is scheduled for one.
And now Randy Orton is officially hearing voices in his head.
Now, if the champion gets disqualified or gets counted out, he will lose the championship. Introducing the challenger.
Ooh, what a fucking stick.
245 pounds.
Randy Orton.
You know, somehow evil shouldn't look that good. I mean, this guy looks like he's
evil indeed, my God.
Ready to do some serious damage.
You know, JR, it's ironic that at the 25th anniversary of WrestleMania, Randy Orton is seeking to destroy the family that started it all, the McMahons.
Well, I can tell you what the WWE title means to the McMahon family. I've known them a long time, known them well. The WWE title has always been the centerpiece of this magnificent organization that goes back four generations.
The WWE title is the one thing left that Randy Orton can take from Triple H.
But will he take it from Triple H? That's the question.
And approaching the ring from Greenwich, Connecticut, weighing 255 pounds, the WWE Champion, Triple H.
I've often wondered if a man can be so focused on destroying another that he forgets that the richest prize in all of the WWE is around his waist. I think maybe Randy Orton is counting on that here tonight. Because remember, if the game is counted out or disqualified, that's as good as a pinfall or submission.
But Triple H is going to have to make a decision. I mean, what's more important, keeping the title or destroying Randy Orton? I don't think he can do both.
Well,
now I think it's perfectly possible to do both.
The important thing in this match for Randy Orton is to win the WWE title. Therefore, the most important thing for the game in this match is to keep that from happening. The question is, obviously,
can it be done? Gotta love that spin a belt.
Oh,
All right, we got three objectives. Perform a spine buster, perform two pedigrees, and a hidden objective. WWE Championship. The special stipulation. Given the small amount of objectives, it's no surprise that shouldn't be too big a deal to do all this. He's wanted to get his hands on Orton for the past few weeks in the worst way. Randy Orton claims that shouldn't be too hard to do this. Explosive disorder.
Orton has delivered his at 24 years of age. Orton made history by becoming
the champion of all time. Suck it.
The skills that this young man has,
I said suck it,
if ever seen.
I don't see any redeeming qualities there.
Randy Orton may not always be a likable guy, but there is no denying the young man has talent. You cannot deny
he has talent, but he's a fucking piss poor loser.
Triple H is not a man that makes idle promises. Triple H has talked about destroying Randy Orton.
Spine buster!
Lights out! The game going high risk! No!
Oh, and he eats a mouthful of canvas.
Now that's how you thwart the attack.
He's got him up!
Oh, the body slam.
I'd rather that than his comeback.
What a despicable kick by Orton.
He was able to reverse that. Oh, man.
Oh, my everything.
Decapitating clothesline.
No!
And a counter. Well, he was able to reverse and get out of that.
Right hand by Randy.
Watch it!
No!
Randy Orton has been World Heavyweight Champion on three different occasions.
Back on the RKO!
Which I think is the motivation for this match entirely. All three
times,
Orton's reigns have been ended by Triple H.
You know, he's the youngest ever world champion. Orton escapes. Man, that was a vicious elbow drop.
Come on!
The methodical attacks by Randy Orton over the past months. When Orton is able to focus on his opponent, like he's doing here, Orton is incredibly dangerous.
This is one of those fights that neither man can lose. Neither man can afford to lose this match. Countered by the game.
He's really come on! The further I go through this goddamn game, the more it angers me.
And the game kicks out.
These guys are giving it absolutely everything they've got.
Triple H saw it coming.
No, blocked.
Oh, how dare you? How dare you? Agony. A sleeper, really?
Away from seeing his breaking point.
Blocks it.
How dare you? Fuck you! Fuck you!
What do you do, King? You've seen this man, Randy Orton, kick your father-in-law in the head. Kick your brother-in-law in the head.
In the head!
Your wife. And that, King, that's where business picked up. That's where it really became a whole different ballgame.
But what do you do here tonight? His hands are tied! Triple H's hands are tied, and he wants to destroy Randy Orton for his sins.
His sins. Okay. DDT!
He's been opened up. He's putting those educated feet to good use.
Orton with a brilliant counter. Oh, what a stiff close-up.
Suck it!
Just driving the head to the floor.
Reversal!
Oh no!
Reversed it. Oh! Look at this!
And this right here is why I don't usually do grapples on Legend difficulty.
Man, there's no getting up from that. We gotta cover.
The kiosk on Triple H. Kicks out easily. Orton.
No!
You can just sense his desire to win.
There's a cover.
No! No, 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 no. No.
Like that takes a lot of power and delivers a lot of impact.
Bitch.
Triple H nails a big time spine on the pine.
No!
What a move! What a smart move!
Fuck you!
The counter.
No!
Oh, nice counter.
Fuck you!
A counter. Triple H, what to do next? How to wear this man down?
Triple H, strategizing, measuring.
Ah!
Oh, what a pedigree! That's it!
Pin him! One, two, three!
The old fat lady singing, boys, it's done!
It is over!
Here is your winner, and still WWE Champion, Triple H.
My God, what a battle. And the King of Kings, the WWE Champion, reaching into the soul of Randy Orton.
Does he even have a soul?
And the game plays on. Well, Randy Orton has learned a very valuable lesson on the stage of WrestleMania tonight. Be careful how far you back somebody into a corner. Especially if that somebody is named Triple H.
All right, all right, all right. For winning that match, we simply get the Mania 25 arena. Now it's time for Mania 26. At the Bash in 2009, Edge and Chris Jericho won the Unified Tag Team Championship. However, their partnership was short-lived when, due to injury, Edge would have to do something. Waiting for it to load, so I can go back to the beginning. Edge had to vacate his half of the title. Jericho immediately distanced himself from Edge, crediting himself for all the team's success. Edge made his return from injury and won the 2010 Royal Rumble. 3 weeks later, Jericho won the World Heavyweight Championship at Elimination Chamber. The following night on Raw, Edge announced his decision to face Jericho for the World Heavyweight title at Mania 26, punctuated with a spear to his former tag partner.
The following contest is
you think you know me.
For one ball, and is for the World Heavyweight Championship. Introducing the challenger.
From Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing 241 pounds, the rated R Superstar, Edge!
Here is a nine-time world champion. Edge won this year's Royal Rumble, which gave Edge the opportunity to pick which champion he wanted to face here at WrestleMania. Chris Jericho won the World Heavyweight Championship inside the Elimination Chamber. So what does Edge do on the next Monday Night Raw? He spears Jericho and says, I want to face you.
He's the ultimate opportunist, JR.
From Winnipeg,
Damn! Break down them walls.
27 pounds, the world
Canada versus Canada.
Chris Jericho.
Chris Jericho is a six-time world champion, a nine-time intercontinental champion, and one of the greatest superstars to ever grace the WrestleMania ring.
Well, Jericho maintains that it is genetics that make him better than Edge. Is Edge prone to physically breaking down? That's the question.
72,219 WWE fans here tonight in Glendale, Arizona. And the WWE Universe watching from all over the world in places like Jericho and Edge's home country, Canada, also New Zealand and Mexico, Spain, Romania, the Middle East, and of course, on the Armed Forces Network.
What a night! What a WrestleMania the world is witnessing.
What a WrestleMania featuring Bret Hart versus Vince McMahon. Surely one of the best WrestleMania matches of all time. Now then, let's actually get to brass tacks. This is for the World Heavyweight title. Chris Jericho versus Edge. Ding!
And we're underway. The World Heavyweight Championship on the line here tonight as Chris Jericho
get out
face off in this long brewing contest.
Now this rivalry goes all the way back to the Bash in 2009, JR. You would not think to look at them, but at one time, Jericho and Edge were the unified tag team champions.
That pairing was short-lived as Edge suffered a torn Achilles tendon, forcing him to the sidelines and Jericho to find a new tag team partner.
And Jericho then teamed up with the Big Show, and he made it well known that Edge had little to do with the team's earlier success.
Edge returned and won the Royal...
All right, we did that. Now we need to do a Lion Tamer, which is Jericho's finisher. Good.
...this year, and then made his chosen opponent at WrestleMania known crystal clear when he speared Jericho at the Elimination Chamber pay-per-view.
You're in trouble now.
Oh, nice counter.
No, not again.
And he threw a hard right hand there. The 9-time world champion Edge takes on the current titleist, 6-time world champion Chris Jericho. Edge and Jericho are former unified tag team champions. This is a deeply personal affair, and there may be no greater enemy than that of a wronged best friend.
Well, let's not forget that both these superstars come from Canada. Edge is from Toronto, Jericho from Winnipeg. They train together. They travel the roads together before coming to the WWE. It's almost like a brotherhood that has been severed. Watch it, DDT!
DDT!
Jericho setting it up!
Come on, get them walls in! Get the walls!
This
the walls of Jericho!
Submission hold and used to great effect here.
Edge reversing. He's putting those educated feet to good use.
These two men know each other's styles like the back of their own hand. They know how to counter. And it's almost...
Lion Tamer!
...what the other's thinking before they do it.
If you've ever traveled through the Great White North, those roads are long. Sitting in the car with someone chasing their dream, you get to know someone. You almost become...
Oh, no! Execution!
These men are so evenly matched. Both are surefire WWE Hall of Famers. Both have excelled on the biggest stages.
These two men have held titles an amazing 55 times combined.
Come on.
That, JR? 55
times no!
combined.
Jericho making his mark on WrestleMania history tonight.
Shit.
His World Heavyweight
Championship.
Well, JR.
Damn it! Too fast!
Championship is on the line. We both know that Chris Jericho
no.
will do absolutely anything to keep it. No, blocked.
Oh, my God.
Damn it.
Oh, God, what impact.
Look at this. It's locked in.
Never.
Got the rope.
Oh, nice block.
Slick move there by Jericho to reverse that. Chris Jericho is a guy with more faces than Mount Rushmore.
He fights it off. Turns it around on him. And what a move.
No. Bad Edge.
Get out of that.
Edge could be in serious trouble here tonight. One has to wonder if his injury is more physical or psychological.
When you come back from an injury like Edge had, you have to try to prove to the world and yourself that you're better than you
Boing!
Were.
Jesus!
For the Lion Song.
All right.
He can hit that from almost any position, anytime.
Codebreaker!
Pin!
One, two, three.
Jericho.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Chris Jericho retains the title.
But Edge felt like a world champion here tonight. He was game. He gave it his all and fell ever so slightly short.
That's the worst thing. That is the worst feeling. Like, you get that close, that little bit close, and they all get ripped away.
Mark my words.
All we got for that was the Mania 26 arena.
Dave, we've both been in the WWE a long time. I've never had a problem with David. As a matter of fact, there were times where I considered him a friend. It's just now he's got a problem with me.
John, you and I are the two biggest stars since the Attitude Era. Our rise to the top, practically identical. We both won championships at WrestleMania 21 and never looked back. But for some insane reason, this company has decided to label you as the man. John Cena, the name and face of the WWE. I should be the name and face of the WWE. I'm the biggest star in this company.
You do this for money. I do this because I love it. I do it for moments like WrestleMania, when Never Give Up stands for something.
You can get all these people excited. Bark, bark, bark. That's what you do. That's not what I do. It wasn't too long ago that I broke your neck. Every time you and I are in the ring together, bad things happen to you. You can't beat me, John. And deep down, you know it.
Batista ambushed Bret the Hitman Hart from behind when Hart and McMahon confronted each other on the February 1st, 2010 episode of Raw. After the show ended, Cena tried to help Bret, but was also assaulted by a dominated Batista. John Cena won the championship from Sheamus in an Elimination Chamber match. Cena's victory would be short-lived, however, as Mr. McMahon immediately ordered a title match between Cena and Batista. With Cena exhausted from his previous battle, Batista easily defeated him and won the WWE Championship. On the February 22nd, 2010 episode of Raw, it was announced Mr. McMahon would give Cena a title rematch as long as he could defeat Batista in a match that night. During their match, Batista intentionally disqualified himself by delivering a low blow to Cena.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and is for the WWE Championship. From Washington, D.C., weighing 290 pounds, the WWE Champion, the Animal Batista.
There he is.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's rather ironic that Batista has been craving the spotlight in recent weeks. And here tonight, here he comes in a lone spotlight. 25 times the WWE title has been defended at WrestleMania. 15 times it changed hands. But King, I can't really recall a buildup in the history of WrestleMania that has been as lopsided as this has. Batista has been absolutely dominant.
I think you're right. It's physical domination and mental domination. I think somehow, and not many people have been able to do it, but somehow Batista has gotten inside John's head. Cena knows he's going to face Batista tonight, and he knows he's in for the fight of his life against the Animal.
It's going to be one hell of a fight, then.
And introducing
it better be one hell of a fight.
From West Newbury, Massachusetts, weighing 240 pounds, John Cena.
It is the salute to the WWE Universe as John Cena is ready to battle for the WWE title.
You know, I just talked about doubt, but right now, I don't see an ounce of doubt on the face of Cena. He looks like a new man. John Cena has said he lives for moments like this, lives for moments like WrestleMania.
This should be quite the match. Our first objective is to hit Batista with a diving STF. Not STF, five knuckle shuffle. What the fuck's wrong with me today? Diving five knuckle shuffle.
This match.
Now, one thing I want to mention here. Batista has resiliency.
So you want to make sure you use that. The WWE
or at least if you're going to try and submit him with the STF, make sure you have two finishers.
They made their WrestleMania
debuts. Otherwise, he will break out using resiliency, and it will be a pain in the ass to get that back.
Cena, an eight-time world champion. Batista, six-time world champion.
And both of these men want to add one more accolade to their WrestleMania record.
Look at him unloading. And now Cena with the Luthez press.
Top rope move coming. Watch it.
And the leg drop. Oh, it misses.
Like that, I'm wondering if he has something in his eye. A big fist to the gut. Nice reversal. A great reversal by Cena.
Oh, ooh, what a slam.
That axe handle had some force behind it.
He fights it off.
This reversal there. One more time. No, not again.
Oh, yeah.
Get him. Get him.
John Cena suffered a broken neck back at SummerSlam 2008.
Now Cena. Top rope.
Batista remembers it.
Leg drop.
Cena. I think that's been the impetus. The broken neck that has allowed Batista to play these mind games on Cena over the past couple of years.
Remember what Batista said to Cena? You can't beat me. Deep down, you know it. But perhaps some self-doubt now growing in the mind of Batista. He's really going for it now.
Fuck you, fuck you.
Cena now, scaling the turn.
Oh.
Here we go. You can't see me.
Damage he can take. John Cena has said that Batista possesses the greatest threat to his career. But Cena says there's something that Batista does. One mistake that Batista makes that he vows to capitalize on.
Well, if Batista is on retaining his WWE championship, he needs to grasp control of this match right this second.
Sent to the ropes. What a counter by Batista.
Cena, just one heartbeat quicker on that exchange.
Look at him unloading with the
fist, 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 fist.
And Cena wrenches. He's applying the pressure. This is such a painful
I guess I forced him to use his resiliency.
This one is
here is your winner.
Hear that, or the game decided to be nice.
WWE champion,
John Cena.
John Cena has exercised his demons.
He has slain the animal.
John Cena has proven that he can beat Batista to become a nine-time champion.
Oh, what a victory.
For winning that match, we've unlocked Batista's Mania 26 attire, along with John Cena's Mania 26 attire. And now, it appears we are actually out of time. But, this is very good. We managed to do four matches in one video, without nearing our time limit. So, I'd like to thank you all so much for watching. When we get back to this, we will be handling The Undertaker versus Shawn Michaels at Mania 26, and there will be plenty more to do for 30 years of WrestleMania. I'll see you guys then.